Hello, I'm Gav.
I'm Dan.
Welcome to the Super Slow Show. Today we have the world's fastest card thrower.
Oh! It just disappeared.
It's like a knife did it.
And a fast draw world champion.
Oh! That was so quick.
That was very quick.
Hey, hello. What's going on?
Rick.
How are you?
Good. What is your speed record?
My speed record? I can throw a playing card over 90 miles per hour.
What? No.
Oh!
Jeez, I reckon I could throw a card.
Let's see.
Yeah?
Yeah, let's see where you're going to throw it.
I'm going to chuck it over here, I reckon.
All right, let's go. That's really actually pretty impressive. Jeez, you try throwing it.
I mean, I've never thrown a card.
That's perfect.
That was,
we'll just cut that.
Okay, yeah, we'll get rid of that.
So how did you figure out that you could throw a card that far?
Well, I'm a magician,
right?
So I always have cards on me, and I was a baseball pitcher. So I put the arts together, I came up with a card throw the same way that I would throw like a curveball or a pitch.
Do you think that you could get a card through the carrot?
It's gonna be really tough, but I will do my best.
Yeah?
All right, here we go. Oh!
I didn't even feel it. Like, it just disappeared.
It's like a knife did it.
Look, that is crazy.
Do you put much work into your concentration face?
Yeah, thanks. That's the problem that I have.
You should probably work on that.
I can't fix the face. I'm sorry.
It wasn't a glance. It actually bounced off the internals of the carrot. The carrot looked top. Now we've repositioned the phantoms over Rick's shoulder. I'm gonna go get some celery.
All right, ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. I'm good.
That is like a really clean cut.
I don't think my teeth could even get it that clean. Jeez. No, messy.
Whoa. Just go straight through.
That's nothing. It's incredibly clean.
Wow.
I love that. It's such a satisfying moment.
Do you reckon you could go through two of these?
Let's try it.
Yeah?
Yeah. All right, here we go.
Yep.
Look
how much it's holding on by.
Just a thread.
Through two. You say you've never done this before.
Never done two before.
Whoa.
Oh, lovely.
And it's falling.
Hold on my thread.
I reckon you could go through two and then maybe even hit a third one.
Do you want to try?
Should we just find the critical celery amount?
Find the critical celery amount, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
It definitely stuck in, but that seems to be the limit.
I think it did hit into it, yeah. So it wasn't inaccurate. It was perfectly accurate. It just didn't go quite through it. So we found the critical celery protection amount.
Whoa. Yeah.
And that was a clean cut on both of them as well.
Yeah, I've never seen anything like that.
Wow.
Rick, phenomenal skills. Thanks so much for showing us your speed.
Yeah, it's really impressive. I was shocked.
Thank you so much for having me on your channel.
Where can people find you?
Just check my YouTube channel out, and you can find me on there.
Cool. Thanks for coming.
Thanks.
Next up in our video of extremely talented and fast people, we have a man who can fire 5 bullets from a handgun in a second.
That's right. We got fast draw world champion John Rivera with us. How's it going, John?
Good. Pleasure. Gavin.
Good to see you.
John.
Hey.
Dan, pleasure.
That was a quick handshake. Like it.
My business.
Because stuff tends to come out of a gun relatively quickly, we're going to use the V2511 today. We'll be rolling at 28,000 frames a second. So, super extreme slow-mo.
Super extreme slow-mo.
Super mega.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Hopefully the shots will come in right about a quarter of a second to 2,200ths of a second. And to put that in perspective, you blink your eyes at 2,200ths of a second.
Seriously impressive stuff.
All right.
Only if I hit. What we're going to be using is blanks. Basically using black powder. And of course, there's some secret ingredients I can't tell you, but we got other powder in there.
Really? As a magnet at the end of the gun and a magnet in each of the balloons.
You boys ready?
Yeah.
Ready.
Oh!
I think one of those was a twofer.
I think the last one was a twofer.
Yeah. We'll count it. Okay, well, let's check out that high-speed footage and see exactly what happened there.
is the balloon.
That was, what, 5 rounds in under a second?
Yeah.
With a manual weapon you have to cock every time. I struggle to do that with a semi. So is it five rounds?
There's almost no time wasted between the hand coming back and the trigger being pulled. It's always ready.
Extremely efficient, yeah. For sure.
So he missed that.
I couldn't tell that that happened.
No.
Oh, he went back for it. That was impressive. He was like, missed that. Next one, going back, doing that again. I was like, what happened? I love how he had 5 shots. He missed one. He was like, gotta get both.
Gotta make this count.
Yeah.
Next up, Dan goes head to head with John. What are your thoughts? Nice hat, by the way.
Thanks very much. It's not so much a cowboy hat as a sitting on the porch hat.
Yeah.
It's like chewing grass.
Keep your strawberries in it.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
This is going to be simple. I'm going to hand you a loaded 45.
Yeah.
You're going to cock it.
Yeah.
You're going to point it at the target, finger on the outside of the trigger, and when the light comes on, all you have to do is squeeze the trigger.
Okay.
Where I am going to draw from the holster, cock it, level off and squeeze, and let's see if I can beat you.
Although, I do have one disadvantage, is that I have to have my finger outside the trigger guard.
Mine will be two.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I have a disadvantage, just the same as yours.
Yeah, but all right, fine.
Okay. All right, are you feeling lucky?
Punk?
Okay. Go ahead, cock it.
I can't hold it.
The next
my
time that light...
too long. I can't be
the
inside.
The next time light comes on, we're going.
All right, now?
Yep.
Oh!
Oh, did you win?
I did.
You won.
Wow, that's impressive. That's seriously impressive. Because all I had to do was move my little finger. You had a whole thing to do. That was really cool.
I'm really fascinated to check out the footage and see how close they actually were.
Yeah.
So this is our V2511 angle. Extremely slow.
It's like he's pulling the trigger and still moving the gun forwards as the hammer's moving forward.
It's like the aim is still coming into place and the hammer's already going towards the bullet.
Yeah. Whoa, the hammer hits, and it bounces back, and then you see the round come out. It's that quick.
It's like a Newton's cradle, though. The hammer goes, and now the bullet's moving. He took one look at you and thought, I can't lose to this schmuck.
Why am I wearing a lab coat and like a wicker cowboy hat?
You look like Doyle, the cowboy scientist.
Oh, that was so quick.
Oh, he smashed you.
I can't believe it. The slow-mo makes it seem like there was such a huge gap, but in real time, it just sounded like one shot, and you can't tell who won.
That's like 0.02 of a second.
It's kind of embarrassing, really.
That's nothing in real time.
Well, thanks, John, very much for lending us your fast draw skills.
I like
my
what you did there.
Pleasure.
Yeah, thank you so much. That was tremendous looking footage.
Thank you.
I'm amazed. I'm blown away by it. Hopefully you enjoyed that video. Feel free to subscribe to the Slow Mo Guys, and we'll see you in the next episode of the Super Slow Show.
I need to practice.
Subscribe.
Hi guys, click here to keep updated on all the new videos we're posting almost daily for the Super Slow Show. There will be loads of them. Imagine the mess we can make with daily videos. It'd be chaos. I'm even slightly worried about it, to be honest.